Absolutely.
Just kind of get a feel for what everyone's up to. Let's do like your name, where you teach, and what you're doing right now in terms of like at school, or maybe like if you're working on a project or something. So just kind of get a sense of what everyone's up to at the moment. I'm Jim. I teach at De La Salle in Warren. And currently I am getting my kids ready for the AP Physics test. And Cedar Point, we're going May 18th, if anyone else is going. I know at least one is going. Brian, what are you up to?
I'm Brian Vitale. I teach in Utica School District, the IB school there. I'm getting my seniors ready for the IB exam. My freshmen, I'm getting them trying to add vectors. And my juniors were playing with sound and making music instruments.
Nice.
I'm getting ready for Cedar Point, going May 23rd, but I take my freshmen. So.
Paul Seri over at Churchill. Getting my seniors ready for the E&M C version. My juniors and some of my seniors ready for the mechanics. My regular kids, my regular physics kids, we're doing, we're starting electrostatics. We just finished up momentum and energy. And we're getting ready for Cedar Point. And they just finished a bunch of projects. We did, for the regular classes, we did mousetrap cars. For my AP class, we did gravity cars. And for my E&M, we did capacitor cars and raced them down the hallway.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah.
Appreciate it. Dave?
David Frank from Arbor Scientific. I'm just here to observe. Not teaching any kids right now.
This is your first meeting all year, right?
That's right.
It's good to see you.
Thanks. Good to be here.
Thank you. I'm Vance Nannini. I teach right here, classroom 123. Got a lot of Arbor stuff.
Great.
So like your rotational dynamics one was a big hit. I told all the kids it made out of a T2 Terminator. With the AP kids, we start our final review for the AP exam. We're working through pre-response questions. Regular, we're doing two-dimensional motion, projectile motion. It's been real solid.
Jim Gell from Plymouth High School. Also on the train to get kids ready for the AP Physics 1 exam coming up in 13 days. And also trying to get ready to go to Cedar Point on May 23rd, because I knew Brian was going there.
Dang it!
Jeff Kahn from Wayne State. Involved in a few things these days, teaching an introductory physics course, an astronomy techniques course, astronomical techniques course. Also, heading up the planetarium again, and there's lots going on there. And pretty involved these days also with a project with a couple of our colleges, engineering and class, and the College of Ed now, with a project that we're trying to work through MSTA, and we'll talk about a little bit about that maybe today, just take a couple minutes and at least get you guys up to date on it. So, just busy, just kind of busy.
Scott Schneider over Lawrence Tech. We're heading into our magnetic field stuff in most of my classes. Analytical is doing oscillating multiple mass oscillating. And I've got a senior project working on genetic algorithms and searching for planets, multiple planet systems and eccentricities in orbits. So that's kind of interesting.
I'm Steve Dickey. Work here at Divine Child. I'm actually the director of instructional technology. I don't teach any physics currently, but I've got an electronics class where we do programming Arduino microcontrollers, and my students right now are starting to work on their final projects, which will be all variable, different things. Then I got a group working on a robot thing, which we were just looking at in there. And I'm filming all of y'all right now with this weird camera that I just got in the mail today, so. It's 360 degrees.
Ooh, really?
So I thought this would be a fun thing to try on the around the room introduction.
Does it pick up audio?
Yeah. There's two microphones in it, so.
On each side?
Yeah. I have no idea how good it is, so we'll find out.
Cal Hutzmer, I'm retired. I suppose my specialty is physics and toys.
I'm Gil Paz. I'm from Wayne State. It's a
trying to finish up all grading for before the end of the semester. And getting ready for, so this summer I'm going to be first time in charge of the CorpNet program. And hopefully all of you have heard of this. So we're just trying to nail details and probably send out some information next month about registering. So those of you not familiar with this is a program where we get 12 kids. So it's a group of four kids coming, doing research with cosmic rays for 2 weeks each, so we can accommodate 12 kids.
Fantastic, thanks.
What's right?
I said fantastic, thanks. I'm
yes.
Sorry, I'm having trouble speaking up.
By the way, they also get paid. So.
Hmm.
That's one of the things I'll have to figure out in the budget. It's not a lot, but it's probably more than enough to cover the lunch. So. And some travel. So.
Well, thanks for coming, everybody. I appreciate it. This is going to be our last official meeting, from what I assume. And I appreciate you letting me be kind of the leader of the group this year. And I'll be passing that on to Vance. not that I'm not going to disappear at all. I'll always be there.
Well, that's as vice president, that becomes the president.
I wasn't knowing about that.
Was this becoming of the MIAPT thing?
But what I am picturing for the last kind of get together is some sort of picnic. I've heard of this picnic in the past, where we can kind of bring physics toys. You know, I don't know, someone's talking about sending a rocket up. maybe Whoa. Some drinks, adult drinks. Maybe if you don't drink, bring some pop. We have some food and, maybe do it that week right when schools wrap up, so we kind of get a casual, you know, bring your significant other if you want, kind of like a laid-back, fun time to hang out and kick off the summer. So that's what I'm picturing, and I'm going to work on this with Vance, he just found out. And I'm curious at what kind of opinions everyone has in terms of when, where, what they want it to look like. Do you want there to be like some sort of like topic or theme or just kind of a free-for-all? So I'm open to any opinions right now, and I'm going to...
Maybe Jim could describe, I think, best, because he was involved in some interesting ways. Jim and Ryan actually both can describe what happened at the last one.
Uh-oh.
It was done.
What happened?
Yeah, I think we did. I think right after school gets out is a good idea, just my personal opinion on that.
Hey,
but
I'm going to need... Find out when that is.
A weekday. We did it at. We went to Kensington Metro Park.
Well, how does everybody feel about Kensington?
Oh, that location, which Jim knew about, was fantastic. Enormous.
Yeah,
we had
this huge
enormous
place.
Area to ourselves.
Yeah, we had tons of room. There was hardly anybody else out there.
Yeah.
So, if you wanted to launch rockets, you could launch rockets, and no one's going to be bothered. You can bring bicycles. Kayaks if you want, because there's the lake there. There's a lot of stuff. You can have adult beverages there, so that's a bonus. So we just grabbed one of the shelters that's there.
You reserve it?
No. It's almost impossible to get on a weekend.
Oh.
But during the week, you just
okay.
show up, and it's first come, first serve.
Oh, okay.
And they've got the barbecue pits there, so we just brought some charcoal and got the grill going for anything anybody wanted to put on that.
Families,
free edition passes.
Kids came.
Yeah.
People brought their kids.
Yep. Steve brought his rockets.
Air rocket.
Air rockets.
What was the device that
the Adelaide?
The Adelaide.
Oh my, that was amazing.
Good. Yeah. That was quite a time.
My son threw it once, and he was an expert in teaching everybody else how to
do it.
Yeah, what you got to do here. Yeah. So, it was
so
fun.
It was
just
really
laid back.
Yeah.
It was good.
And Norbert Vance at EMU?
Yeah.
He brought his solar,
solar
telescope.
Yeah.
No, yeah.
All those things are possible.
Sun's proud of
them.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's right. Solar scopes.
That was pretty cool.
Bring
while the sun was not.
You look at the sun with
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The Rickon filter.
Just hold it up your eye. Really cool.
You only look for a short
no,
time.
Ryan,
he's liable to do that sometime. And there goes the. Yeah.
He
He's in a mentally precarious state. You can remember that.
just look real quick.
Brian told me that through the lens of the sun.
Well, an eye patch meeting.
that's the fact.
All right, so this is what I have right now. The picnic at Kensington on a weekday, the week that school gets out, there will be beer, charcoal. Bring your own food to grill. So if you want to bring a 12-pack of hot dogs or if you want to bring a steak, it's up to you kind of thing. That way we don't have to worry about RSVPs and ordering food. I think that's probably a good idea.
We did come up with, we brought some things, though. We tended to get a bunch of pop, maybe?
Sure.
Should that, I mean, there were a few things, a few basics that we, I think, right?
Or utensils. So pop, utensils.
You need a committee of about two or three to make sure that certain things get there.
Right.
You just do a Google Doc for signing up for things, and I think that it'll self-organize.
Any other input from everyone?
So some of you know when school ends. Mine ends differently than yours does.
Yes.
Third week of June? Okay.
Third week of June. Is everybody out the third week of June? Is anybody not out?
Yeah, the only problem is the E&M modeling workshop starts on June 21st. Which, if it's in the evening, it's not available.
Well, the third week is the 13th.
That's a Tuesday.
Oh, it does start on Monday.
Monday the 20th?
You got it Monday the 20th? Sounds good to me.
Good for me.
Monday, June 20th. Best day of the year.
Is it E&M modeling?
Yes.
All right, any other input? Vance, did you kind of catch all
I did.
A little bit of that?
We may have coordinated also.
We got everybody. So Vance and I will, and then we'll kind of delegate duties for people to bring things in. There is quite a bit of money in the DMAPT account right now, which is at the Christian Financial. I've been just depositing all the money from dues and food into the account, and I've been using the card from the bank, the debit card from the bank, to pay for the food. So right now, I think I want to give a rough estimate about $700. I know we did put about a few hundred dollars into paying for the science center on the first meeting of the year. So anyway, that's kind of like the state of our bank account, and we can probably put some of that money towards the picnic utensils and things.
Space balloon? Yeah, maybe a space balloon. And a drone.
To bring it back.
A drill?
Drone. The balloon goes up, right, and then it pops, and then it falls down, and you got
to
track
find
it. But if you have a drone that, like, once it reaches a certain pressure, kicks in and GPS goes back.
How quick can we get this together?
It'd be tremendous. Steve doesn't do anything during the day.
Or at least tag the balloon with a GPS chip so the drone can zero in on that and go from the tree.
Sure.
All right, where do you guys want to start today? Saw some Cal brought in some interesting stuff. I know Jim had a good idea for us to kind of brainstorm before Cedar Point.
I got some stuff. I'll just
Paul's
give you that real
quick.
Paul's got
some good stuff.
I put together a bunch of this. I thought there'd be a lot of people. So I got stuff that I've done over the last 30 years. Books, some of the old books that are online, the Welsh book, some of the stuff from Esavar, some of the old articles. They're all on a CD or a DVD. So if you guys want one, I'll just pass them out. Just take one and then go. I didn't label it.
Paul, do you want me to project?
Yeah, you can project and see. There's a ton of stuff. You know? So I don't know what's there.